Ladies and gentlemen, people of the internet and you festive little weirdos, welcome to the show. This is the game of the decade episode. And this is more a personal episode. This is my game of the decade, a game that I have personally played in the past 10 years that affected me personally, personally. It's a game that has had a very serious impact on me as a gamer, as a semi-professional video game enjoyer, and has had huge ripples throughout the games industry. The only issue that some of you might have is that this particular game came out in 2007. And that's last decade. This is underdeveloped. Team Fortress 2. So I know that TF2 came out in 2007, but for me, Team Fortress 2 wasn't released until 2010 with the Mac update. This feels a bit confessional, but I used to be a Mac user for a long time. As a creative professional, I drank that Apple Kool-Aid hard. In fact, I still watch all the Apple keynote presentations. I guess you could say I'm a non-practicing Apple user, you know, still there for the holidays, just not as devout as I used to be. So let's go to the Wayback Machine 2008. I pick up the orange box for my Xbox 360 because I'm hearing that this Half-Life game ain't so bad. I play through the game and then all the episodes, all two of them, and it's brilliant. Then I take a stroll through Portal, amazing, of course. Something to know about me is I've never really gotten into online shooters before. You know, as a console user, kind of my only entry point was either Call of Duty or maybe a Halo. And to me, those games were always filled with chaos and instant death once I spawned. Never really got into them. Call of Duty to me was always a meat grinder, whereas Team Fortress 2 was more of a chef's knife. It cut with precision and grace. Does the other team have a heavy that you can't push through? Then be a sniper, that'll take care of them. Does the other team have a sniper that's really good? Be a spy, that'll take care of them. Does the other team have a spy that's giving you problems? Be a pyro. There is always a balance if you get stuck. And really, if all else fails, Uber charge. Medic was always one of my favorite classes and especially useful when I was learning the game because, you know, you could just stick with your team and follow along. That's a quick public service announcement for anyone who's looking to get into Team Fortress 2. Just be a medic. It's a great way to learn the maps and the balance of all the classes. Also, if you've been playing TF2 for a while now and want to change things up, try being a medic. It's always a great way to help your team. I guess what I'm saying is just be a medic. We don't need 5 snipers. I've always played and enjoyed games, but it was usually a passive experience. The 1,000 plus hours I have put into Team Fortress 2 made me look at that game and all other games in a more critical light. Stuff like character design, knowing what an enemy is going to be just by looking at its silhouette, map design, balancing player strengths, audio cues, all things that I can't help think about now because I've spent so much time listening for spies to decloak, or listening to see if there's a sentry around the corner, or knowing which weapon to switch to when getting in a fight with a pyro. TF2 gave me more to think about. Other games are just, go kill that guy. Yeah, him. We don't like him. So, now we move on to the year 2009. 100 plus hours into TF2 on my Xbox, I hit a skill cap and I'm trying to break through it. I started doing research and I came across this little known art form. I don't know if you've heard about it. They were called Let's Plays. And you see, here's the crazy thing. It was people showing their video game footage on the internet. That's the other part of this that makes it a personal thing for me, was Team Fortress 2 was my introduction to people talking about video games on the internet. All of these creators, Stir, Jerma, Stabby, I'm sure there were others, I just can't think of them right now. They all had fantastic videos. Tips, tricks, sentry locations, how to rocket jump more effectively, strategies, all sorts of wonderful things. It was great, and I loved watching them, and I loved getting more immersed into the TF2 community. But these videos also highlighted my biggest problem as a gamer, my Apple problem. New content was coming out to TF2, new maps, new game modes, new guns, but they weren't coming to Xbox 360. And I had a Mac which couldn't run Steam. So for a long time, I would use these Let's Play videos as almost nicotine patches, just hungry for more TF2 content. I memorized rollout strategies for payload maps that I couldn't play. But then, in 2010, Steam comes to Apple computers. And just 2 days later, they patched it so it actually worked. Team Fortress 2 is the first game I buy for Steam, and it's the only game in my Steam library for 2 years. Literally. Here's a fun fact. The second game I purchased after 2 solid years of Team Fortress 2 was The Binding of Isaac. So I played a lot of TF2. 2 years, 1,000 hours worth of TF2. And now I have access to the robustness of playing on my personal computer. I get all the new game modes, all the new guns, all the new content, and I get something I never knew I needed, which was customization. The ability to remap buttons now that I'm playing on my personal computer. TF2 led me to the world of PC gaming. It was like being teleported into the future. All the stuff I wanted, all the customization. Why doesn't everyone know about this? Oh, they do? Oh, and they just don't care? Oh, you don't care, never mind. Once you start gaming on your computer, you get access to smaller developers making smaller, more unique games. I was learning the technology of how games were made and how they run, leading all the way up to building my own computer, which I'm using right now to edit this episode. It's the best. I love it. When I jumped back into Team Fortress 2 just this week to capture all of this gameplay footage, I was really excited to see that not much has changed in the game. You know, there's still mic spamming assholes. There's still the people that play way too competitively in casual servers. And there's still people goofing around too much in casual servers. And there's still unspoken meta games. You know, if you ever see a heavy who has his boxing gloves out, you can't shoot him. You have to melee fight him. That's the rules. I don't make the rules, I just follow the rules. So, Team Fortress 2. It opened me up to being more critical of games, which now is part of my career. It introduced me to gaming videos online, which is now part of my career. And it set me on the path to be a PC gaming snob, which is part of my career. Really, just for the hours that I've put into it alone, Team Fortress 2 is my game of the decade, even though it came out last decade. As a side note, here are some actual games that came out this decade that make kind of my best of list. Breath of the Wild. It's hard to think of another game that gives you the freedom and gives you the feeling of true exploration that Breath of the Wild gives. Games like The Binding of Isaac and Spelunky for literally redefining a genre, ushering in a new wave of roguelike mashups, fantastic games. Duskers is a game that completely challenges my thought on proper controls in games. It's one of the most unique games I have played this decade. Bloodborne, just for its cohesive story, gameplay, themes, and, you know, personally just for getting me into the Souls series. Beautiful game, Bloodborne. Rocket League, for bringing back co-op. You did it, Rocket League. It's so great. And Doom. Doom 2016 for, you know, for being Doom.